Hola, amigos de cancha, estamos aquí con el delantero del Monterrey, Vincent Janssen, que nos recibe hoy en el Barrial para esta entrevista exclusiva para cancha. Vincent, thank you for having us. It's a pleasure to be with you.
Thank you.
How is it feel to be here in Mexico? You've been 3 months. How has been the process of adaptation to the league, to the team, to a new country, a new city?
Yeah, very good. Since the beginning, I needed some time to get full fitness because I came from not playing that much in the last couple of years, and I'm very happy that I'm here now. Everyone helped me from the first minute to adapt as quick as possible, and I think I did very well. I tried hard to adapt as quick as possible to the culture, to the people, and yeah, it's going well.
It's been a good experience so far here in Mexico for you?
Yeah, very good. Yeah, I like it a lot. Amazing people. The club has been very good. Obviously, the results are not yet what we want. But I think if we win this weekend, we're in the playoffs, and then anything can happen. So,
is Rayados, La Liga MX, what you expect for? What would you be?
Yeah. Everything what they told me in the beginning, before I signed here. After 3 months, you have a very clear view about everything, and they have been honest about everything. The club has been so good to me, and it's an amazing opportunity here, and you really feel that Rayados is a huge, a very big club.
You've been in the Netherlands, obviously, England, Turkey. Is it too different what here in Mexico, what you used to?
No, I don't think so. I don't think it's different. For me, the mentality, the environment of the people in the club, yeah, I think you can compare it to Europe. Obviously, there are a few different things. I think in every country is a bit different. For example, Turkey was much different if you compare it to England. But I think Mexico, the way how Rayados is top. Yeah.
These facilities that Monterrey has, like the stadium here, El Barrial, it's a nice place.
It's an amazing place.
It helps people like you to get.
Yeah, that's what sometimes if I'm in Holland or if I talk with my friends, it's very difficult to explain how beautiful it is here. The facilities in El Barrial and the stadium, they are amazing. And I don't think that people back in Europe realize how good it is here with everything what the club established. It's very nice.
After several months dealing with injuries, like you said, now you are getting consistency here in Rayados. You are playing more often. You are scoring goals. Mm-hmm. How does it feel? How do you feel right now that you are playing, making what you love?
Yeah, it's very good. I miss that feeling. And yeah, you start to lose a little bit the faith in everything and in football. But I'm happy that I got the opportunity here to take the chances back. And yeah, in the games that I've played, in the cup, in the league, in the friendly games we had, I've been trying to give everything, and I think it's I think I did well.
What would it be, or what would you say was the hardest thing to do in those times where you fighting injuries, knee, ankle, all that?
I think the hardest thing is to wake up every morning, go to the training. And you know you cannot go to the pitch. You have to work inside, where you see everyone going to the pitch every day, to see them playing games. And yeah, you just do your recovery and try to get fit. But it's very difficult because you have to get your motivation from your memory, from what you remember of playing games. And yes, it was a very long way. But I'm happy that I'm fit again. I don't have any pain anywhere anymore. So yeah, that's a good feeling.
You miss that, to be okay for every week's game.
Yeah, exactly. I miss that, and obviously to train every day, to smell the pitch, to smell the grass. Yeah.
In Holland or in England, in Europe, or even some people here will say that you coming to Mexico is a step back, but it looks like you, and you said it at the beginning, that it is not, it's moving forward in your career.
Yeah. I think it's, for me, it's a very good step. It's no step back, because I think the league in Mexico is a very good league. There are a lot of players with a lot of quality. And yeah, it's not it's not used that players from my age go from Europe to Mexico, but that didn't hold me back, because I tried to see everything open. And when I had the conversations with other people here, I got such a good feeling that I wanted to take the opportunity. And when I see how the quality is in the team, how the quality is in the league, I think if we would play in Europe, we would compete in a lot of competitions.
At the very beginning, when you were not having so much minutes in the pitch, but when you got finally in the field, the people were saying it was like a perception out there that your teammates didn't give you the ball enough. Mm-hmm. And they say, Denzel Jansen, pass it to Jansen. Did you feel that too on the pitch?
No, I never had that feeling. No, for me, I never had that feeling. I think my teammates, they've been trying to help me from the first minute I came in. And they will never do that. I'm sure of that. And I believe in my teammates, and I know that my teammates believe in me. That's for me completely a rumor, which is, it's not true.
It's just to have fun.
I don't know, maybe people wanted to put that into the world. I don't know why, but I never personally, and I never had that feeling. And I know for my teammates that that's not true.
How has it been, the relationship in and outside the pitch with the teammates? I don't know, Gallardo, Layún, that you appear so much in social media.
Yeah, no, I think we have a lot of funny guys in the team. There are a lot of nice players. I think everyone has a really good character in the team. And you always have to see the beauty in the people. And I think it's going very well. I'm having fun here outside and inside the pitch. So I'm enjoying.
And you will keep enjoying as long as you have minutes in the pitch. And the people now, and I think there's a little bit of debate about whether you play or Rogelio Funes Mori. Mm-hmm. They want you in the starting lineup. How does it feel that the people claim you?
No, for me, as what I said before, it's especially at this moment, it's not about persons, it's about the team. And which players the coach picks, he picks. And as a team, I think it's very important that you fight all together. And we all need each other. We all need each other. So Funes is done very well. He's been so important for us. And the coach picks, and the person who picks is going to show it, and the other person who comes in have to show it after. It's how it is in football.
So far, it seems like for the coaches, and every game is a decision between you and Rogelio Funes Mori. Mm-hmm. But I want to ask you, how do you feel better? How it suits you better? Alone in the attack, or with Rogelio Funes Mori or another guy alongside?
No, I think I can play with one striker, I can play with two strikers. It just depends on the coach. And in the end, it's football. It's football, and if you give everything, and I'm sure that whatever position you play at some point, if you have the quality and you do well, it will work out. And especially with the team we have, because there's a lot of quality inside. I think you can play in a few formations, and I think it's also good for the coach that he has the possibility to pick players. And that's very good for him, for us as a team. And the team is the most important. So everyone who's playing has to be ready, and who's not playing also have to make sure that whenever you come in, you have to be ready.
The tournament started with Diego Alonso as coach. Now you have Antonio Mohamed and up front. Does anything have changed for you since the El Turco arrived?
No, because it's difficult to talk about coaches, because I think they're both very respectful, very nice persons. and they both have their own qualities. I think Diego was a very good coach. He had a lot of quality. He had a vision about how he wanted to play, and he was a very good man. And the same for Mohamed now. I think he has a different way of playing, but he's also very successful. And he's also a very good and respectful man. So I think they are both good coaches, but they have different way of playing, but they were both very, very good persons.
How do you get in touch with him? How do you speak to him? In English, in Spanish?
Both. A little bit English, a little bit Spanish, and sometimes we need some help to communicate. But that's going very well. And the language of football, you can communicate with each other. And sometimes there's a third person who helps us. And sometimes we can communicate half English, half Spanish. So we will get there.
Are you taking a Spanish lessons?
Yeah, I've been very busy with Spanish lessons. I have a very good Spanish teacher. So we're having fun. We work hard. And hopefully soon we can do this interview in Spanish.
Perfect. This weekend you have an important match. It all figure out to Monterrey having chances to make the playoffs, and it's only a matter of beating Atlas de Sarre at home. Mm-hmm. So how do you and the team are getting ready for the match?
Normal as every match. The players from the national team will come back, I think tomorrow or the day after, and from then you can really focus on the game. Of course, it's a very important game. Is the game where we've been fighting for together all season. It's not our best season, I think. But that's what I said, if we finish at the eighth position and we go to the playoffs, then everything is possible, especially with the confidence we have, because we have that. We know we are a very good team. So if we win on Saturday, which we are very sure that we will, and then we will see.
It looks like you can turn it all around in just one match.
Yeah.
No matter what happened in the 16 past games.
Yeah, I think we've been a bit lucky that we have it still in our own hands. And we have a big opportunity this weekend, a very big opportunity. And I think the big teams, they show and they stand up in those moments. So it's on us. And yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's just on us and we will show it.
That's the main thing. It's on you. Mm-hmm. It only depends on you.
Yeah, we're very happy. And that's what I said. We've been a bit lucky with all the results lately. But that's the opportunity we got. And we have to make sure that we take this opportunity.
Hopefully you get that win and that to stay in the competition. And that will help towards the Club World Cup in December.
Yeah, another big opportunity to show. I think if we talk in my situation, I think I would really like to show Europe or stuff in the world that Mexico, what we are as a team, that we can do a lot of things. And that I know a lot of people are watching the World Cup. It can be really nice to as a team perform the really good.
And it should be a great tournament. It could be River or Flamengo. It's already Esperanza of Tunis. Yeah. Outside of Xavi, it seems like Liverpool, it seems like a great stage.
Yeah, I think it's an amazing stage for a team to perform. And I think it's, you can write history, and that's an amazing opportunity.
Vincent, I know what will be a good participation in that tournament, in the World Cup?
It's difficult to say, but I think if we go in there, you get in the quarterfinals. So there are hopefully three games to play. And I think we all know football is a game where everything can happen. So if we go there, for the biggest what we can get. Then obviously we're trying to get to the first place. Everyone would do. We will see how it's going to go.
I know you have been in Mexico only in about 3 months, but what would you say that you like the most about your experience about the country and the city personally?
I think the people. The people have been, I can see the people here are really family, people. They're very, very nice. They have a very good heart, and you feel that they're trying to make you enjoy it as much as possible, make you feel home, and they really take you into their country and to show the best of it. And everyone which I've met, everyone is a nice person, and I think in Europe we can learn a lot from that. Yeah, it's really nice to see how the people are.
How are we doing with the Mexican food?
It's good. It's good. It's a bit spicy sometimes, but no, I prefer to don't eat too much of the spicy Mexican food. But it's really good. I like the food a lot. Yeah.
And the weather? Winter is coming.
Yeah, it's weird because 1 week ago it was 5 degrees and now it's 30 degrees. But
welcome to Monterrey.
Yeah. No, I like it. I've been the last couple of years in very cold countries. So to be now in a very hot country, it's nice. And sometimes I make my family jealous when I FaceTime or Skype with them and they are cold in the night and I show them the sun and they're like, ah, it's nice to be in a country like this with the weather. It's very good.
Because in England, well, foggy and all, it's really rainy most part of the year. So
yeah, this is good. It's good sometimes to wake up and to walk out of your apartment and yeah, you feel a good temperature. It's a nice experience instead of going to the training in 5 degrees or less and have the rain. And yeah, it makes you feel a bit more happy, I think, to have the sun.
So far, it's fair to say that you're enjoying here in Monterrey.
Yeah, I enjoy it a lot. Yeah.
Well, there you have it. I want to thank you, Mason, to give us this opportunity to chat, to know you a little better. I don't know if you want to send a message from the people of Cancha and the Rayados fans?
Yeah, no, it's not a message. I think I'm just been really happy with how everyone has been supporting me. And I think, keep doing that. Keep supporting the team, because especially in this period, we need everyone to stand behind the team. And I know that if everyone's standing behind us and we will give everything, there are beautiful things which can happen in the next couple of weeks, months. So let's do it all together.
Muchas gracias, amigos de Cancha, por seguirnos en esta entrevista con Vincent Janssen y gracias por recibirnos aquí en el Barrial. Hasta la próxima.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you.